Good morning everyone. Ojaswat IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affairs for helping you in the coming exam of UPSC prelims 2020. So today we will discuss the MCQs of 14th March, but before that you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. And please take a pause when you see question on the screen, then answer it. And if you feel the video is going too slow, too fast, please adjust the speed of the video accordingly. Please utilize your time properly, as we have been left with very few days. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos and try to get at least 7 questions correct out of 10. So let's begin our today's MCQ. Question number 1 is with reference to Freedom in the World 2020 report. First, the annual report is published by United Nations. Second, India has seen the worst fall among the world's 25 largest democracies this year. So here statement first is incorrect, second is correct, so option will be B, second only. So the Freedom in the World 2020 report has been released recently, which has ranked India among least free democracies in the world, which is unfortunate. And the report has been released by Freedom House, which is a US-based watchdog tracking global political and civil liberties in countries. That's why statement first was incorrect, and the report ranks India at 83rd position out of 195 countries, and India's score fell by 4 points to 71, and the worst decline among the world's 25 largest democracies this year. And the reason for low score are the annulment of autonomy and the subsequent shutdown of Kashmir, the National Register of Citizens, that is NRC, and the Citizens Amendment Act, CAA, as well as the crackdown on mass protests in India. These were the reasons behind. Now question number 2 is with reference to mercy petition. So first, there is a statutory provision in Indian Constitution for mercy petition. Second, Constitution provides for a specified time limit to accept or reject the mercy petition. So here both the given statements are incorrect, so option will be D, none of the above. So there is no statutory written procedure in Indian Constitution for dealing with mercy petition, but in practice, after extinguishing all the reliefs in the court of law, either the convict in person or his relative on his behalf may submit a written petition to the president, and the president can either accept or reject the mercy plea as per the advice of the Council of Ministers. So do remember this fact, as per advice of Council of Ministers. However, Constitution does not provide for a specified time limit to the acceptance or rejection of the mercy plea, and he can keep the petition in hold for an indefinite period if he wish to do. He here means President. Now question number 3 is with reference to black red star. So first, the species of birds is endemic to Central Asia. Second, the IUCN status of the species is vulnerable. So here statement first is incorrect, second is also incorrect, so option will be D, none of the above. So this is the image of the bird, and the black red star is a small ribbon sized bird breeds across the Himalayan range, and this bird frequents the plain of India from end of September through March, and it is resident of South and Central Europe, but the birds migrate to winter in Southern and Western Europe and Asia, including India and North Africa, and it breeds in the high altitude areas of Kashmir, Ladakh, Tibet and Central Himalayan range, and the status is least concern under IUCN. Now next question. Question number 4 is Pragyan Conclave 2020 is an initiative of which of the following ministries? So the correct answer is Ministry of Defense. The option will be C here. So this conclave is a 2-day Indian Army international seminar which is being organized by Center for Land Warfare Studies, commenced on 4th March in New Delhi, and the initiative is taken by Ministry of Defense, and the event brings together a cross-domain international and national expert to deliberate on the complex subject of changing characteristics of land warfare and its impact on the military. And the seminar provides a platform for deliberation on emerging ideas, perspectives and narratives that defines the new age warfare, which is increasingly witnessing a change in its character as well as battlespace, with the usage of new means to pursue the ends, and the need of comprehensive transformation of the armed forces by taking a wider view of the changing security dynamics was emphasized. Now, next question. Question number 5 is, Garrison recently news is located in which of the following state of India? So you might be knowing it. The correct answer is Uttarakhand. So option will be C. So this is Garrison and here is Dehradun. And this Garrison has declared the new summer capital of Uttarakhand, and it partially fulfilled an over 2-decade demand of statehood fighters to make it the permanent capital. And the statehood activists had long contended that Garrison, a tehsil in Chamoli district, was best suited to be the capital of mountainous state, as it was a hilly region falling on the border of Kumaon and Garhwal region. And the Dehradun is located in Garhwal Plains, have served as a temporary capital of the state. And the state assembly is located in Dehradun, but sessions are held in Garrison as well. So do find out which other state have multiple capitals. Now question number 6 is, recently the Supreme Court set aside a ban by the RBI on banks and financial institutions from dealing with virtual currency holders and exchanges. So the statement first is, the court held that the ban did not pass the proportionality test. Second, there is no globally accepted definition of virtual currency. Third, cryptographic methods are used to make currency secure. Fourth, virtual currency is a larger umbrella term for all form of non-fiat currency being traded online. So here, all the given statements are correct. So option will be D, all of the above. So Satoshi Nakamoto is widely regarded as founder of modern virtual currency, which is Bitcoin, and the underlying technology called blockchain. And the Bitcoin is defined as a new electronic cash system that's fully peer-to-peer with no trusted third party. And this essentially meant that there would be no central regulator for virtual currencies, as they would be placed in a globally visible ledger accessible to all the users of the technology. And the test of proportionality of any action by the state, the court held, must pass the test of Article 19(1)(g), which states that all citizens of the country will have the right to practice any profession or carry any occupation or trade and business. Now, next question. Question number 7. Recently, the term MAC binding was in use. First, every device have a media access control, that is MAC address. Second, while accessing the internet, every device is assigned an IP address. Third, MAC binding essentially means binding together MAC and IP addresses. So here all are correct. So option will be D, none of the above, because no statement is incorrect. And recently, after 7 months, the use of social media was allowed in Jammu and Kashmir, but internet speed in Jammu and Kashmir is still restricted to 2G and with condition of MAC binding. And MAC binding essentially meaning the binding of MAC and IP addresses together, so that all requests from IP addresses are served only by the computers having the particular MAC address. And in effect, it means that if the IP address or the MAC address changes, the device can no longer access the internet, and also monitoring authorities can trace a specific system from which a particular online activities are carried out. So this might be a potential question. Now question number 8 is, recently the National Coalition for Men was in news. So first, it is a non-profit educational civil rights organization. Second, it aims to address the ways sex discrimination affects men and boys. So both are correct. So option will be C. So operating since 1977, this organization is the oldest organization of its type in the United States, and military conscription of men alone is one of the issues that this organization is advocating against. And in US military, registration with the Selective Service makes it mandatory for men aged between 18 to 25 to register with this service in the event that a national emergency requires a rapid expansion of the armed forces. And as opposed to the USA Selective Service, there is a universal service required in some countries, such as in Israel, under which all the target population is expected to serve in the armed forces. So the organization is based in USA. Now question number 9 is, with which of the following religion is Anekthavada philosophy is related to? So the correct answer is B, Jainism. So option B is correct, because Anekthavada refers to the Jain doctrine about metaphysical truth that emerged in ancient India, and the origin of Anekthavada can be traced back to the teaching of Mahavira, who was 24th champion Dakara, and the word Anekthavada was coined by Acharya Siddhisen Devakar to significant the teaching of Mahavira that truth can be expressed in indefinite ways. And the Jain doctrine of Anekthavada emerges to be a social attempt at equality and respect to all diverse views and ideology through the philosophical elucidation of truth or reality. So Anekthavada is related to Jainism. Now question number 10 is, Nehru Swaraj was recently new, so where is this place located? So the correct answer is A, Afghanistan. So here you can see and check out in the map, here is the place in Afghanistan, and it is the Nehru Swaraj district, which is also called Nehru Swaraj, is a district in Helmand province in southern Afghanistan. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And in the last, positive quotation is, I will win not immediately but definitely. So work hard, be consistent, regularly watch our videos. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the videos. Please like, comment and share the video. We will meet tomorrow with the next MCQ. So take care, have a nice day, and thank you.